Today we're here to announce two projects totaling $18.5 million. The first will make immediate repairs to this Loyola station. The second involves environmental work necessary for the CETA to modernize the red and purple lines. These projects are moving forward thanks to $11 million in federal funds. I can tell you they were secured years ago before we entered the current controversy, and now they are finally coming together with local and state funds to get this project underway. What you're looking at in this transit system is the second largest mass transit system in America. We should also understand that the Red Line carries more than a third of the passengers on that transit system. The station behind me is in desperate need of repairs. If you take a look at some of the viaducts, beams, and columns supporting the station, you can see they need some work. Federal funds are leveraging private and local dollars from Loyola to make improvements to this station and bring it back to a state of good repair. It'll include upgrades to the viaduct and better lighting and visibility for safety. The project will also move the station entrance a little further north, and this will increase safety for pedestrians. This station isn't alone. The Loyola station problems are symptomatic of the problems all across the Red Line, and that's why we're beginning the environmental study necessary to replace, rebuild, and extend the Red Line. It's the heart of the CTA rail network with 250,000 rides each weekday. But it's also one of the oldest lines. Some parts were built in 1900. Federal funds we announced today will help the CTA move forward with their vision for a newer, more modern Red Line. It'll also allow the CTA to conduct environmental analysis to modernize existing red and purple lines and extend the Red Line to 130th Street. We're in a time of terrific challenges when it comes to funding, but I will tell you this. Despite the budget difficulties in Washington, and there are many, we should never lose sight of the fact that if we don't make an investment in the infrastructure of America, we cannot build our cities, build our towns, communities, and neighborhoods for jobs for the future. That's why investment in mass transit, in public transportation, is absolutely essential. We are now talking about a new federal highway bill. The suggestion in the House side is that we cut federal spending on this by one-third. It would be the first time in 56 years that we would reduce federal funding for public transportation and highways across America. It is a step in the wrong direction for us to do this. We've got to make sure when it comes to our infrastructure in America, we put Americans to work with good paying jobs right here at home, that we build the infrastructure that supports the businesses large and small, that we strengthen our cities and communities and our states all across the nation. Today's announcement is a very small part of it, but an important part. And it's an indication of what investments need to be made.